in arrigo, you're wanted at the town hall. Don't be late. Salvatore Civinini. Next time you're late with your taxes, you'll be fine. Peppino Arrigo. Peppino Arrigo. Where she got to?
Here I am.
Ah, there you are. Don't forget, your taxes for Violette are due next week.
Taxes. It isn't one thing, it's another.
Hey! You're going to get us into a lot of trouble. The education officer from Perugia was here, and he wanted
to know... That's all right. Father D'Amico's taking care of his schooling.
But the law says...
The law says all sorts of things. Peppino, seen one of these before?
Is it old?
About 800 years. Where did you find them?
The monastery of St. Francis. We're repairing the foundation of one of the staircases.
Who's the contractor?
Signor Strotti.
He sent you with them?
Yes.
Then they can't be worth much.
Violetta! Stop that. Don't you know that he's stealing? We're in enough trouble already.
We've got to work hard today.
They're after me to go to school. Now they've made us late for the market. Come on. And don't forget to smile.
That smile.
To the prettiest donkey in Assisi.
Oh, come along then. My wife is waiting.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning, Peppino. Don't be late this evening.
It's market day, Father.
I know, quick as you can. Don't forget your books.
No.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning. Good morning. A tough little fellow. A businessman at 7. Comes from a farming family down south. His home was blown up and his people all killed. American corporal found him in the barn with a donkey. Came up here with the American army.
Did you know, Violetta, the signora will pay 100 lire?
What? To my place. 50's all she'll get.
I'm sure the signora will give you some 90, Violetta.
Don't you believe it? The others were willing to do it for 50.
But they're just ordinary donkeys.
What is special about yours? She's very small.
But she's willing, and she has a lovely smile. Violetta, smile, little lady, who's going to pay 75 lire.
Oh, you can't tell me that donkey smiles.
She's famous for her smile.
Look, I really believe she's smiling. Give him 75 lire.
What? All right.
Thank you, signore. Thank you, signora.
Thank you.
Mrs. Tartley.
Peppino! Hi! Stop there!
I'm on a job!
I can see that. When you finish, get down to the station and collect two cases. They're statuettes of St. Francis.
If the statues of St. Francis, Violetta, we'd better do it.
Even in advance!
My husband will take care of that.
But it's in Paris, the last time.
Now, none of your cheek. Get along.
Coins?
That's right.
What do they get for now?
Treasure.
Treasure?
He thinks he's funny, Peppino, but they say the treasure of St. Francis is buried near here.
Where?
Somewhere up by the old entrance to the tomb of St. Francis, which was walled up in my grandfather's time.
Well, if he's right, Peppino, and we find it, we'll give you a diamond necklace for Violetta.
It will suit her better than Mrs. Torti.
Hey!
Look out!
I'm working hard this morning, I see. I thought you were collecting my cases.
I am.
When?
Now.
You'll be telling me that donkey of yours is doing the job for you.
She is.
The coins were of interest, but of no value.
Of course, Father Superior. That's what I taught myself. But I'm always hoping one day we may hit upon the treasure of St. Francis.
Do you believe that the saint who was known as a little poor man could leave an earthly treasure?
There are many of us who still do.
Father. This time you can tell me your work. I'll have your license taken away.
Well, the job's done.
Don't be ridiculous.
But 200 is a proper price.
Here's 50. Now, get out.
I said they cheated Violetta. Careful, Violetta, you'll break them.
I'll teach you to break my things.
Don't you touch Violetta! No! You throw!
Ah, go away.
Signor Peppino, tonight the roads are altogether too unsteady.
You don't want Elisabetta to give you another black eye? Come on, I'll take you home on Violetta.
Violetta? A lovely young lady to see me home.
Come on, up on your feet.
E la notte is good.
It will cost you 200 lira.
What else? Keep the change.
That too much.
Wonder. Huh? I said keep it.
What?
Oh,
cura, quando dormire non poter.
What's the matter?
It's Angelica.
But what is it?
It's Angelica. I think she had an accident. Anyway, she's sick, and her hind legs won't work anymore.
Oh, I hope she'll get better soon. Good night.
Good night.
Forget you. You were a good girl today, Violetta. So we can open the parcel. I wonder what's in it this time. Thank you. What did I tell you? It's your favorite candy. Wait. It's you, Father.
Yes, when you didn't come for your lesson, I thought I'd better look in on you.
I meant to come, Father.
You ought to be careful about going to sleep with that lamp burning. From your friend, Corporal O'Halloran?
Yes.
What happened to your arm?
Nothing.
Someone did that to you? You've been fighting again, Peppino. Come here. Easy. It's nothing serious. You could do with a wash, you know. I see you looked after Violetta. And how's business today?
Oh, we had a good day. And Father? Hey, one is nice.
It's 2 years since he went away and he still remembers you. He's a good man, your friend O'Halloran.
And here the photo, too. Look, there he is, and that's his wife. There's a message on the back, but he didn't write very clear, you know.
Perhaps you do not read very clear, you know. I tell you what we'll do, we'll try. We'll make this your lesson for tonight, Now.
Hello, Peppino, what do you know?
I am now a papa.
I have a little boy. Little boy. How is my sweetheart, Violetta? Violetta. And my kind regard to Father Amico. Don't forget what I told you. Keep your nose clean, do a day's work, and never think of for an answer.
From your old friend, Corporal Francis Xavier O'Halloran, formerly Corporal USA AF.
That's good advice, eh, Father?
Yes, for a young fellow like you who wants to get on in the world. And I think Corporal O'Halloran would like you to use this soap in the morning. And don't forget, Peppino, tomorrow we're all going to make our pilgrimage to St. Francis. Good night.
I have a job in the morning, early. Please, Father, couldn't you leave just a little later?
We'll wait for you.
Good night.
Good night.
Night.
Are we all here? Ah, Peppino! Does anyone know why each year we meet here outside the Church of San Rufino?
Yes, Father, because St. Francis was christened there in the Church of San Rufino.
And secondly, because nothing here has changed very much since the time of St. Francis. More than 700 years ago, he stood by this fountain on a bitterly cold day in winter and gave his only cloak to a beggar. You see, St. Francis believed that true giving was to give what you needed most to someone who needed it more. Here in our town, it is almost as though he was still with us, as though at any moment we might see him striding through the streets singing. And so, in case we shall meet him, let us sing a song on our way to the cathedral that bears his name.
Non ti scordare di me, della bianca stella alpina.
Now, children, before we go into the cathedral where St. Francis is laid to rest, what can you tell me about him?
He loved us!
That's right. And they loved him. He even preached a sermon to them. Now, what else?
He loved flowers.
Yes, he did. He loved everything that grew.
He loved animals.
Yes, he loved all God's creatures.
He
And did he love kittens too?
Indeed he did, Jenny.
And what about donkeys? Did he love donkeys?
I'll show you.
Peppino, there's St. Francis with the donkey. Go and look.
Francis, as a young man, renouncing the world to devote himself to the service of God. The great Giotto, who painted these scenes from the life of St. Francis, loved him as we do.
Thank you.
Assuntina. Good night, Maddalena. Good night. Good night. You got a nasty cold, Violeta. Never mind. I know where to get something to make you better.
Is this the one? How about this one?
Call me Brown, that's it. That's the stuff.
That coffee maker would be good for, for anybody.
Why, yes.
I have two bottles.
Two bottles? What do you want all that for?
It's for Violeta. She has a bad cough.
Your little sister? Is she in bed?
No, that's my donkey. Do you think we'll be all right to take it?
A donkey? Well, I sell gallons of this stuff to dozens of donkeys every week, and it doesn't seem to do them any harm. Now, if this young lady,
Violeta,
doesn't respond to treatment, I suggest you take her along to Dr. Bartolo, the veterinary. Thank you.
I've got some very good stuff here, Violeta. You see, you're going to like this. Violeta, please, you must take it. It'll do you good.
Peppino, Peppino, open the door. Peppino.
Shh, quiet. Violeta is sick. She got a cough. I gave her some medicine. I wanted to go to sleep.
Oh. My mother wants some firewood tomorrow. I'll help you cut it.
All right, if your aunt is better.
My kittens are a lot better. St. Francis cured her.
Can she use her hind legs again?
Well, not exactly, but she can drink milk again.
Oh, really?
Yes. Goodbye, Peppino.
Good night, Johnny.
Good night.
Thank you. Maurice, what goes on here? What do you mean by waking me up in the middle of the night like this?
Pino, please come down. Violeta is sick.
Oh, your donkey is sick. Well, can't it wait till the morning?
But she's terribly sick. I think she's dying.
It can't be as bad as that. You go home and I'll come round in the morning.
Look, I have money. I can pay you.
You know, I charge double when I come out at night time.
I'll pay you double.
Very well, then. Stay where you are. I'll come down shortly.
This is much more serious than I expected. I don't like it. No, not at all.
But what is it? What's the matter with her? Can't you make her well?
There was a similar case in Foligno last week and another in Perugia. The pathologists are still examining the remains in an effort to discover the cause of infection. Well, I have done the best I can for her. I've given her something to help her breathing and ease her pain. Let her rest there, light diet, and if God wills, she may live.
But you must cure her! You must make her well!
She may go on till the end of the week, and then, poor thing, we must hope there will be an end to her suffering. Well, good night, young man. Don't take it to heart. Remember, there are lots of other little donkeys in the world. Good night.
Don't be afraid, Violeta. I know what to do. Tomorrow I'll take you to St. Francis.
He'll make you better. I know he will.
Now you must go to sleep.
Yes, yes. What do you want? What are you doing with that donkey blocking the entrance to the door? Can't you see that people want to go into the church?
Please, Father, that's what I want to speak to you about. Violeta is sick. Dr. Bartolo says she's going to die. Could I take her down to St. Francis and ask him to make her better?
What? You want to take a donkey into the crypt of St. Francis? Don't you know it's forbidden to take animals into the church? As for the holy tomb, I've never heard of such a thing.
Well, St. Francis loved donkeys, and I'm sure St. Francis will love Violeta and make her better if he could just see her smile.
Now, stop talking nonsense and move away from here. Animals are not allowed in the church, and that's final. Now, go away, please.
Peppino, I'm afraid not. If the brother told you that it was not permitted to take animals into the church, that would seem to be the end of it.
No, not for me.
Oh, and why not?
Because of what Coppola Halloran told me.
What was that?
He told me to never take no for an answer. And if I don't take Violeta down to St. Francis, I'm sure she will die. Who is above the brother at the door?
The Father Superior.
Could I go and ask him?
There's nothing to stop you.
You wish to see me, my child?
Are you the Father Superior?
Yes. Well, what is it?
It's about Violetta. That's my donkey. She's terribly ill. The tobacco says she may die. Could I take her down to the tomb of St. Francis? They love little donkeys. I know he will make her well.
A donkey? In the crypt?
Well, when someone I know skating can choose the back legs, just... Well, there is this person, took her to St. Francis and asked him to cure her. And he got better. Well, almost.
Really? And how did this someone you know succeed in smuggling a kitten into the crypt?
Under his shirt.
Well, you can't smuggle Violetta in under your shirt. My child, don't you see that even if I were to permit it, you could never get a donkey down into the tomb. The stairs are so narrow, and there is a sharp bend. So you see, the whole thing is quite impossible.
But there is another way to the tomb.
What other way?
The old passage from the cloister.
But that was walled out 150 years ago.
But couldn't they knock down the wall?
What? Tear down church property? No, no, my child. Go home and pray to St. Francis. If you open your heart to him, he will hear you.
But that isn't the same. I must say, well, St. Francis can't see her. She's unlike any other donkey. She has a lovely smile.
I'm sorry, my child.
But she will die.
That will be as God wills.
Yes, Peppino, what is it?
Father, please, you must tell me, who is above the Father Superior?
Father General of the Order.
And who is above the Father General?
The Holy See.
And above the Holy See?
The Holy Father himself. Listen, Peppino, they're all good men, and I'm sure their hearts would be touched by your wish to save Violetta through the aid of St. Francis. But they're all very busy with the great affairs of the church, and it would be quite impossible for you to see them.
Yes, 200 lira for her food. Take care of her.
I promise.
Feed and water her in the morning and evening.
Yes.
Give her the pills 3 times a day.
Yes.
Keep her straw clean and dry. Wash out her nose and mouth with a sponge.
Yes. You showed me how, Peppino.
And talk to her sometimes. Talk to her and stroke her when you have time. She likes that.
I'll do all that, Peppino.
Swear?
I swear.
Swear by St. Francis and the hind legs of your kitten.
But, Peppino, I don't need to. I love Violetta, too.
Then I can go.
He won't be here today.
But I must see him at once.
Then you must go to the Vatican.
Oh, Vatican.
Thank you, Father.
I wish to speak to him about my donkey Violetta, who's ill in Assisi.
Now listen, son. Do you think His Holiness has nothing better to do than to waste his time talking to little boys? Now, run along.
But if I can only tell him about Violetta, I'm friend of Father D'Amico's.
I don't know who your Father D'Amico is, but I do know it's impossible for you to see the Holy Father. Now, run along, eh, son? No.
Thank you.
what you think you are up to.
I want to see the Pope.
Well, that's not the way to go about it.
But I must talk to him.
So, you want to talk to him, eh? Well, you are out of luck. People ask permission and then wait for months and months for an audience. Now get away from here.
But couldn't I, if it's for a very special reason?
No.
The first spring flower. If you really want them very much, you can have them for 100.
Thank you, Signor.
Thank you, Signor.
Lira. Thank you.
Have you got a pencil?
No.
Here you are.
Thank you. Please take this to the Pope for me. I know he will see me when he gets them and read what I've written to him.
All right. What are you doing with those flowers?
I was told to get rid of them.
You don't throw them away. Give them to me. Very well, Father. And I'm to tell them at the bronze door that Father Ray will be with your party tomorrow. Thanks very much.
Let us know what's written on the card with those flowers.
Indeed, I will.
Dear Holy Father, please let me see you and tell you about my donkey Violetta, who is dying. I want to take her into the tomb of St. Francis so that he may cure her. I've come all the way from Assisi to see you. These flowers are for you, your loving Peppino.
Where is Father O'Brien? He should be here by now.
Father.
there you are at last, Father O'Brien.
Good morning, Father.
Well, come on. Come on in. Have you got that list of names for the audience?
Oh, yes, of course, Father. I thought perhaps you might like to see this little boy.
I'm afraid I have no time at the moment, Father. Could I have that list?
Very well then, Father. Here we are, Father. Oh, no. Yes, that's it, Father.
Thank you. That's all. Well, what is it?
That little bunch of flowers, Father. I put them just there.
What? In the basket? Really, Father? Those letters were for Monsignor's signature. What will His Excellency think?
Take these flowers to Monsignor Magana. Oh, and this note too, please.
Monsignor Magana sends his compliments.
Very touching. But I'm afraid there will be no opportunity of bringing this to the notice of His Holiness today. Thank you.
No use waiting.
But I must see the Pope.
Go away now.
You again? You can't wait here. You can't see the Pope. It's absurd. It's impossible. Now, get away from here. Hey! Stop him! Now, look here, young fellow. If I catch you, within an hour of the Vatican once more, I'll hand you over to the police. Now, go on. Run it off.
the Pope?
No, and there won't be.
How strange. Look, the boy is crying.
I rather think it's the flowers that are weeping.
What is this? And how, I wonder, did it get there? But this is extraordinary and very touching. I will see if I can take this to His Holiness myself.
Never take no for an answer.
Closes in half an hour.
What?
The museum closes in half an hour. No charge for the child, madam.
What?
No charge for the child, madam.
Well, what are you doing? You can't wander around here by yourself.
I'm with them.
Well, run along and join them.
Do we see the rooms where the Holy Father lives?
Oh, no. You're not allowed in there.
Do we go near them?
Yes, you'll pass right by them. Now, run along.
Thank you.
All these paintings that you see were executed by Raphael and his pupils between the years of 1514 and 1517. And now we pass into the Constantine Room, so called in honor of Constantine the Great, the first Roman emperor who became a Christian. It contains the largest painting in the world of a battle. It is the Battle of Saxarugra, fought in 312 AD, in which Constantine defeated Maxentius. Is known as the Raphael Loggia and was designed by Raphael himself. Across the courtyard of San Damaso are the windows of the private apartments of His Holiness the Pope, which can be reached through this door. We are now going to the Stanza Greca, or Greek sculpture room, so called because it is shaped like a Greek cross. We must hurry, please, as there is not much time left.
I wish to find a little boy called Peppino. Yes, that's right. Heimgarten.
Yes, Sergeant.
Do you know anything of a little boy called Peppino?
Yes, Sergeant. I know him.
I believe he was waiting at the bronze doors.
Well, is he still there?
No, Sergeant. I chased him off. I told him if he ever came around here again, I'd hand him over to the police.
Oh, you did? Well, that's a pity. It happens that the Holy Father wishes to see him.
The Holy Father?
In this gallery, we have the resting form by Praxiteles, Eros, god of love, the upper part of a Triton by Scopas, and Lizard Apollo by Praxiteles. The highest holy and the bottom.
Thank you.
your name?
Peppino.
Ah, Peppino. Changa. Where have you been?
You're just the fellow we've been looking for. You're coming with me. The Holy Father wishes to see you.
There you are. I knew he did.
She's not better, but she's not worse. Father D'Amico and I brought her in here because it's warmer. And I thought she'd like the company.
Did you see him?
Yes.
Well, what did you say to him?
I told him about Violetta. And I told him about St. Francis. And the Holy Father said he knew about St. Francis.
He did? And did he say anything else?
He said he thought Coppola Halloran must be a good man. And then he told someone to write a letter, and they gave me this. To get well now. Get up. St. Francis is waiting for you. Please try. When you go to see St. Francis, Violetta, you must smile. Promise me you'll smile. Oh, Father.
Good morning, Peppino.
We're nearly ready. The Father Superior did get the letter.
Yes, I took it to him myself.
And the wall will be taken down?
Yes, otherwise I wouldn't have come to fetch you.
Then nothing can go wrong now.
Listen to me, Peppino. Because you loved Violetta and wanted so much to save her, you took on a task that seemed impossible. But with faith such as yours, simple faith that knows of no doubts, all things are possible. And you can now take Violetta into the crypt, into your friend St. Francis. And you will pray and you believe that he will hear you and intercede for you, and that she'll be made well again.
Oh, yes, Father.
But, Peppino, have you thought that St. Francis who cared so dearly for all God's creatures, might come to love Violetta so much that he might wish to have her near him for all eternity.
No! I didn't go all the way to see the Pope just so St. Francis could take her. He wouldn't do that. St. Francis can't have her. I won't let him.
Peppino, think. Will you go into your friend St. Francis only to ask? Or if you must, will you be prepared to give?
No, he can't have her. I will tell him he can take her if he must. But oh, I hope he will let her stay with me.
Has seen fit to reward your lover, St. Francis, and we, his servants, welcome you. Violetta.
Good morning, Father Superior.
Good morning. Good morning. Go in, my child.
Heritage of St. Francis, the poorest and yet the richest man that ever lived. A length of cord to teach us to be humble. An ear of wheat and a spring flower that tell us of the riches and the beauty of the earth. A feather to remind us of the birds that lift our spirits on their wings and carry us to heaven.
Already they return to dust.
Father, please, may I take Violetta in now?
Yes, my child, and may God go with you. Did you notice? It seemed to me as they went in that the little donkey smiled.